Firstly, here's some ways that God speaks. Number one, he's your life coach. Proverbs 3 and verse 5 says, trust the Lord with all your heart and do not depend on your own understanding. Seek his will in all you do, in all you do. And he will show you which path to take. If you listen to God, he will direct you and help you make the best decisions. Now, I know we can make decisions, but are we making the best decisions? I know I would have made some rubbish decisions had I not asked God for direction. I've made some rubbish decisions asking God for direction because I wouldn't listen. So listen up. There's a reason why the Bible tells us that faith is the only way to please God. And I don't mind preaching that because I think we spend a lot of time trying to get right with God when we're already right with God, thinking that that's the way to please him. But the Bible says the only way to please him is actually to have faith. And I believe the faith that we need to please him is the faith to know that we're already right with him and there's nothing else we can do to make ourselves any more righter or righteous. And it says also, wisdom is the principal thing. So you've got this mix of faith being the only thing that pleases God, and then you've got wisdom being the main thing, the principal thing. Now, these two aren't at odds with each other. They've got to work in tandem. In other words, we've got to use our faith. We've got to have the faith to apply the wisdom. So they work together. In fact, they work really well together. They were made for each other. And I think sometimes people operate too much in faith and not enough in wisdom. And I think at other times people operate in wisdom and not enough in faith. You hearing what I'm saying? Like some people are so full of faith, but they have no wisdom. So they'll go off and they'll do stupid things in faith. But if they'd applied a bit of wisdom, oh, I don't need to go there, do I? Equally, there are people that are so wise that they actually don't think they need faith because they're quite capable of making their own decisions. And I've seen people do that and look at them and I think, well, that was a bit of a crazy thing to do, but there's no telling you because you think you've got all the wisdom that anybody needs. How about now having some faith? Now, here's where wisdom often operates when people think that they've got enough wisdom to live life without faith. They become cautious. So they think it's wise not to actually step out of the boat, because that would be a bit silly, wouldn't it? Because no one can really walk on water. See, that's what wisdom does if you don't apply the faith. Now, the faith is there to say when to get out the boat and walk on water. And if you think of that story, it was on Jesus' command. If Peter had just got out of the boat when he just thought it would be a good idea. Equally, if Peter had never had the faith to get out the boat, he would have never experienced that situation. Now, when does the Bible tell us that he started to sink? When he took his eyes off Jesus, when he stopped listening to what Jesus was saying, he started to sink. Why? I think because he was applying a lot of wisdom and too much wisdom and too much logic, and he didn't apply the faith. The faith and the wisdom go together. So God really wants to advise us, direct us. In fact, he wants to be our number one advisor in life. And in order to hear him, we've got to shut out opposing voices and interfering frequencies. Sometimes that can be people. Sometimes that can be people that you even know and love dearly. And sometimes you've just got to retune. See, more often than not, we argue with the logic of what God is telling us and what we're hearing. Because it doesn't make logical sense to do that. Can you imagine how Peter was feeling that day? When Jesus is out on the water and he goes, walk out to me, you'll be okay. I mean, everything in Peter is going, what? I mean, I'm just processing the fact that you're walking on water, let alone me walking on water. That is crazy. How can I even do that? I know that if I get out of here, I am a fisherman. I know about water. I know that this stuff will not hold me up. See, we don't trust what we're hearing sometimes, and so we argue with God. But God works at higher levels, in higher ways, with higher thoughts, so therefore we've got to tune in to a higher frequency. That's why I'm encouraging you to listen up. Let me just tell you a story about advice and God prompting in us listening, a personal story. A few years back, 7 years back I think now, we'd lived in Lockinthorpe. At that point, I think, probably about 14, 15 years. And we'd always believed for a house on the back road of Lock-In that overlooks the countryside. And we had a friend who lived there, and we'd been there for dinner several times. And every time we'd gone into his house and looked out of his back window, the view was just incredible. The houses along that road were primarily expensive. There were about three in the middle that would have been in our price range. I remember we went to the States. We were ministering there for 2 or 3 weeks. While we were there, a house went on the market, and it sold immediately before we even came back. And we didn't know it was for sale. So we were driving back, I think even on the day that we drove back from the airport, we were driving into the village, and we saw this house, and we went, when did that come on the market? That must have come on the market and sold while we were away. So we phoned the estate agent. They said, yeah, it's sold. I said, is there any chance that it might become available? No. The price, everything was about what we could afford. I felt God, and Lois felt God that day, just prompting us, speaking into our spirit, if you like, saying, I want you to pray over this house until it's yours. I want you to drive past it every day, and I know that sounds crazy, but I want you to drive past it every day and claim it. Do you know, we did that, I think, for 3 or 4 months, every single day without fail. If we were away, we'd still pray for it. And every single day, and periodically I'd phone the estate agent, and they'd say, no, Mr. Radcliffe, it's still not on the market. But I said, but it still hasn't gone through. No, it hasn't gone through, but it's going through, but it's not available. And it's not going to be available, I thought. You wait and see. I know different. Anyway, we thought we'll push things along a little bit more, and so we met with our financial advisor. This didn't make logical sense because, you know, how could we even get this place? We hadn't sold our house. We were not in a position to buy. As we're meeting with our financial advisor and he's working the figures, and I still don't know to this day how he worked them, I'm not asking the question. Creative. So, you know, we're talking to him about it, and I get a phone call, and it's the estate agent. And the estate agent says, Mr. Radcliffe, I'm thinking, of course, she's sounding like a dog with the tail between his legs. Mr. Radcliffe, you won't believe this. We can't quite believe this, but the house has become available. It's fallen through. Would you like to put an offer in? So we put an offer in. We put it in for less than it had sold for, and it was accepted. And you know, the amazing thing about that story is not only was it accepted, not only was that house, not only is that house the house that we live in today, but we got a mortgage for that one as well as the other one. Now that's not fun, let me tell you. I make that sound very glamorous. That was not glamorous. That was not God's plan. That wasn't our plan. I'm not sure what God's plan is. I've never worked it out. And so yes, we had 2 mortgages for a whole year, and we were paying both. I still to this day don't know how we did it, We had to make some real hard decisions. But you know when God is just speaking into your life and you just know that he's speaking into your life? And so we still have two houses, and I know that sounds very glamorous, and there are days when I just wish we had one. In fact, there are days I wish we didn't have a mortgage at all, but I'm praising God that we are in the house that we prayed over and claimed, and we did it because God spoke in to our spirit. He wants to do things in higher ways. In Proverbs 2 verse 1, it says, "My child, listen to what I say and treasure my commands. Tune your ears to wisdom and concentrate on understanding. Cry out for insight and ask for understanding. Search for them as you would for silver. Seek them like hidden treasures." So listen up, because he wants to share some great advice with you. Makes me want to